In today's After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this fun and organic loading animation. Hi, my name is Manuel. I'm a freelance motion designer, bringing you fresh animation and motion graphics tutorials every week. Stick around till the end, there'll be some tips and tricks along the way. Let's dive right in. We'll use the title and action save for more orientation. Choose the pen tool and draw a horizontal line somewhere below the center of the screen. No fill, stroke color white, width 5 pixels. We name the shape line. Then we double click on the ellipse tool to add a round shape. Let's choose a bright yellow fill color, no stroke. We hide this little chain here and change the size to 30 pixels width and height. Don't forget to name the shape. Let's start with a jumping ball animation. We set a keyframe for the position at the beginning and move the shape up to maybe here. Then we go to 15 frames and move it down while holding shift to move in a straight line. The center of the ball sits on the line. You'll see later why. Then we go to 30 frames and copy and paste the first keyframe. Then we select all three keyframes, copy and paste them again. We paste them at 60 frames and one more time at 90 frames. Now we select all these keyframes, open the graph editor, make sure the snap icon is activated and edit speed graph is selected. We select the first point, drag it down to the line and at the same time drag the handle to the right. Then we grab the second point, drag it down and move the handle slightly to the left. Third point, handle slightly to the right. Fourth point, handle way to the left. Until it looks kind of like a weird M. Now we repeat that for all the other move cycles. By the way, if you like my stuff, please consider subscribing. It would mean a lot to me. Alright, organic jump, done. Next, let's take care of the shape itself and get rid of the stiffness. We set a keyframe for the scale at the beginning, height constraint proportions, and set the scale to 110%, width and 95% height. Then we move to 8 frames. During the fall, the shape will morph into a thinner and longer form, so we set the scale to 95 and 110. Then at 14 frames, we set another keyframe. At 16 frames, right after it hit the line, it has the opposite form, so we set the scale to 120 and 90. At 20 frames, somewhere halfway up, it will be thin again. We set the scale to 95 and 110%. At 26 frames, we set another keyframe. At 30 frames, we select all keyframes, copy and paste them. We'll repeat that at 60 and 90 frames. Finally, we copy the first keyframe to the end. Alright, the ball is looking nice and wobbly. We need to take care of the line now. Let's open the path property of the line. At 14 frames, right before the ball hits the line, we set a keyframe. At 15 frames, we grab the pen tool and add another point in the middle and drag the point down below the ball. We form a nice round curve here. At 16 frames, the line bounces back up, shooting the ball in the air again. At 17 frames, it bounces down again, but less than before. At 19 frames, back up a tiny bit. At 22 frames, it's a straight line again. Let's copy the first keyframe and paste it here, much easier. We select all keyframes, copy them and paste them at 44, 74 and 103 frames. Adjust the line if necessary or even the speed curve of the ball to get the position right. Let's have a look. Awesome, a jumping animation that feels organic. Next, we add an effect to the ball. To make the shape a bit smoother, we add echo. Set the echo time to -0.003. The number of echoes to around 20, starting intensity to 1, decay 0.5. If you don't like to see single shapes in the echo, change the echo time to something like -0.001 and increase the decay to 0.7. Great, so much smoother. Let's add some fun text. I use Noto Sans Regular, which is an Adobe font, size 40 pixels. Type some stuff in, whatever you want. Center it and position it below the line. We set a keyframe for the position at 18 frames, move to 15 frames and move the text up towards the line. We add Easy Ease into both keyframes. Then we need to fade it in. Set the opacity to 0, set a keyframe, and at 16 frames, we set it to 100%. That's a short fade. Let's move the start point of the layer to 15 frames and the end point to 45 frames. Every time the ball hits the line, the text changes. We simply duplicate the text layer, move it to the right and replace the text. It looks like the ball and the line squeeze out the text. One last thing. We need to count up to 100% to show progress. So we add another text layer, size 30 pixels and type in a random number. Alignment to the right. We duplicate it and replace the number with the percent symbol. Then we place the two solids below our text layer. We select the layer with the number and go to expression controls and add a slider control. Then we open the slider control in effects and the text property and link the source text to the slider. The number in the slider property appears as source text. Let's set a keyframe at the beginning and set the slider to 0. At the end it's of course 100. What we see now is there are way too many numbers, we need to round them. So we open the source text property and add math with a capital M dot round brackets. We delete the closing bracket though and add it again at the end. Way better. Now we need to go to 17 frames and set a keyframe for the position. Then go to 15 frames and move it up a little to close the gap before the first text appears. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like, so see you there. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. Hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you in the next video. Bye!